Hey everyone, I'm Shane Mack, one of the co-founders of Squared Away, and Coda pretty much saved our life, I would say. It's one of those tools where a year ago I had no idea the possibilities of everything that it can do, and then we spent the last few months really building it out, decided that we needed one place to kind of be able to run payroll, keep track of everything across all of our teams, and really be the core of our company. Instead of having random spreadsheets everywhere, people sending emails between different teams, everyone using a different tool for a different use case, and kind of bring it all together. And so after building it out in 2020, it's kind of changed our company and changed how we work. And I'm just excited to share with everyone how we did it.
Awesome. So yeah, let's jump in and just really quickly walk through how the doc works. And you can tell us maybe about these different pieces of the doc. Let's start with connections. And Shane, maybe help us understand your business model and how those connections are made.
Yeah, Squared Away is simple. We're executive assistants that are all military spouses. So we work completely remotely. We don't have an office. We have over 150 assistants and over 200 clients. And this is the core of everything, is how we match clients to assistants based on personality, based on skill sets, based on tools. And once they're connected, this is how you end up powering payroll. But there's a lot of nuance that goes with a connection. There's people might leave on a maternity leave. People might take vacation. There might be a 3-hour add-on. They might change the plan on the 17th day of the month. And so all those little nuances we needed to be tracked. And when that change is made, it updates the payroll. So no one has to do anything later to hit one button. And our goal of this whole project was, can we make one button, click it, and an entire payroll can be run? And we finally got there, and it starts with the connection between the client and the assistant.
Yeah. Oh man, I love that. It's, you know, boiling it down to one button is very cool. We'll show you that button in a second. So to your point, Shane, in this part of the doc, you know, here's where you can match up client, assistant, plan, and then this kind of forms the base of what happens next and downstream, like you mentioned. So you start here, add your connections, and then you come to pay periods, and walk us through kind of what this process looks like. Every 2 weeks, it looks like you run payroll. What does this typically look like on your team, and how do you use this section?
Yeah. So our director of finance uses this. This is the kind of the full truth. Like this is our record of truth at the company. And every change that's been made across any document in Coda is reflected when you hit the add new pay period button. And that is calculating the working days for that pay period. That's calculating every single change of any plan or any date or any add-on or any time off. All that is done in the doc you just saw, so that our director of finance can literally hit add new pay period. It automatically calculates that there's 9 working days in the last pay period and adds it to a line item. You can click it and see. You hit run, and then it starts calculating all of the payroll and kind of connections, plans, changes to the plans, and does all of the math in the background with a simple formula, and it outputs the payroll amount, connects to Gusto, and everyone gets paid.
So this really is the magic button. That's so cool. So in case you missed it, let's do that again. So what Shane has built here essentially is this is the one button that runs payroll. What we're doing is actually adding rows to the table here in payroll line items. And we've added 13 rows in this case. And you're using formulas to calculate the totals, you know, assistant, client, and even I love this one, which is a description for Gusto. It's worth also looking at the formula that Shane has built here, which is, back in pay periods, to calculate working days. You have to take into account, you know, not only like when did the period start and when did it end, but there's also some holidays that go into it. So you want to subtract that out. This is one of my favorite formulas in Coda, which is the networking days. You can actually just say, hey, here's a list of holidays that I have. Go take that out of the equation when you're calculating working days. So yeah, very cool. And then this seems like kind of the last piece of the puzzle. What do you guys do then once you have this kind of automated list of payroll items?
Yeah, so this is really an audit trail. So, because everything's automatically done. So, you know, you already have the numbers. You can go pay out of Gusto. It sends an email to our finance email alias that goes to our bookkeeping team that has the snapshot, the hard copy that you can't change, the PDF. But then this is where you could go change things and audit things if you needed to make any updates. And so, you know, this is a very simplistic version that you're seeing here, mm-hmm. but most of the time you'll have coverages and you'll see 3-hour add-ons and different plan types and all these little one-off types things all get added up and then get outputted here. And each line item is actually recorded per assistant. So you can see that there's 4 different things happening for one assistant and each of those have a little number. And then the little sentence gets written so that, you know, the assistant knows why they're getting what they're getting and what mm-hmm. changes were made in that pay period. And it's all done automatically.
Yeah, it's super cool. I love how you've combined formulas and buttons. So in this case, you're using this concatenate formula and you're just taking bits of these different columns and combining them into one thing that it reads like somebody maybe would have written that by hand previously. So very, very cool. I think that's pretty much the crux of the doc. Is there anything else that you'd like to point out here about how this doc is structured and how it drives your business forward?
Yeah, the client admin area, I like going there and even showing the log coverage, because when you click log coverage, this really shows that our team makes one-off changes to a lot of things, but you have this history kind of log that is saved on a client level and on an assistant level. And so in this scenario, you know, someone needs to cover for someone taking a maternity leave. Well, we need to update the connections doc, update the subscription doc, update the financial payroll doc, make sure that that assistant is also paid for the coverage time period that's the 13th through the 17th, but then go back to the other assistant once that's done. And all this is happening. And on the front end, all our team has to do is pick a couple of dates, pick the reason, vacation, and then it does all of that other stuff in the background. And then once that date ends, it resets it all so that that connection goes back to how it was before. And then in the payout, you see a different color for the person getting paid for coverage versus the person getting paid for the regular connection. And having that fully coded and just built in a formula inside of Coda is just amazing.
That's so cool. And it looks like you're using Blue here for kind of the long-term coverage or long-term plans and connections. And then this orange here is for the coverage. So when we just added that coverage to the log here, it will then show up in connections. And then after we click the magic button in payroll, it shows up in the payroll line items.
I think the thing that we did is we looked at where we were using spreadsheets in our business. And we started with each role, what is their spreadsheet and how do we bring it into Coda? But with the long-term vision of how do we bring each role into Coda and make the tool work inside Coda so that they all work together. And now we're to a point where everyone's working inside of Coda. So when the salesperson comes in and it hands off to the connections team and it gets matched, and then that goes to the finance team, we aren't handing between 5 different systems. We're all improving a single record of the system. And I think that's the real power.
So this has become kind of your source of truth.
It's the source of truth. And I think that we even have now in our doc, because this is a simple version of it, we have the audit one that is the full breakdown. We have the hard copy that you can't change. Mm-hmm. So we've really gotten to a place where, you know, we even have backups and the hard copies and audits so that we can go back and look at it, know if anything was wrong. And it is the source of truth of the company.
All right. I think that's it.
No, thank you. I hope everyone enjoys it. If you have any questions, we have our contact info on there and anyone can reach out and say, hi, I'm Shane at GoSquaredAway.com. My co-founder and the CEO, Michelle, is Michelle at GoSquaredAway.com. And we're happy to help.